Yeah, all right. So first off, I want you all to stand up. Don't worry, you'll sit down again real soon. This is just my try at doing stand-up comedy. No, actually, I have no idea if I understood that right. It's probably something completely different. Now, I want to ask you some questions on your daily actions. So question number one, do you at home separate your waste? Do you separate into plastics, into green? If not, that's all right. Then you can sit down again. So questions. Yeah, well, if you separate something, that's all right. Question. Yeah. Everyone understood? Good. So question number two is, are you one of these people that run around and switch off the lights everywhere? You know, the ones that everyone else leaves on all the time? If you're not a person like that, it's all right. You can sit down. Then the third question. Do you pee in the shower so that you don't have to flush the toilet an extra time? If not, you can sit down. Oh, this is not my idea, by the way. I expected only me to be standing here, but there's three very wonderful people, heroes. An applause for these people. Very good, very good. You can sit down again. Yes. That's three times more than I expected, so that's great. My topic for today is climate change. And we have written so much about it, millions of books and articles. And we all see this threatening message that they give. They paint a very dark picture of the future. And, well, the thing is, how do we know what's really going to happen? These are not just predictions. These things have actually happened before. Because, for instance, in the Permian era, there was a 6-degree increase in average temperature, and it killed 95% of all species. Only one large land animal survived. Well, we look nothing like this, so clearly that's not good. We don't want an increase of 6 degrees. So why are we not taking massive action? Let's take a look at where we're standing right now. We can safely burn around, well, 300 gigatons more of CO2. Well, the problem is we have way more fossil reserves than that. And you can say we can just leave most of it below ground and everything will be fine. But a lot of it is already sold right now. So companies that have made this promise to sell, they have to go back on their word and go bankrupt. So clearly, we can expect no help from them. If they don't deny climate change, they will die. Their organization will cease to exist. Also, well, 97% of all the scientists agree that this time is our fault. It has happened in the past, but this time we are to blame. But many people don't agree on this, even though the experts do. And why is this? This is because of the media. I'm not saying the media are corrupt or biased. No, actually, they're doing their job. They are journalists. They have to be impartial. They cannot pick a side. So they frame it as an equal debate. And this is then what shapes the public opinion. And then people that hear these messages, they go and say, well, I like warm weather. Global warming is going to be good for us. But I've already talked about that. But if you're part of one of these groups of people that are not concerned with climate change, then you don't want to be the person, the black sheep that goes against that. There are some psychological reasons why we try to bury this feeling of guilt or that we should do something. We stay inactive because the threat is uncertain. And when we're uncertain about a threat, our brains, they're great at coming up with excuses and all these kinds of biases. You know, something bad, it will always happen to someone else, right? You don't expect to die in a car crash, but you hear about it all the time. There's so many examples of bad things happening to other people. And this creates, well, it becomes normal to hear bad news. And we have only so much that we can worry about anyway. We're way too busy with our own personal problems to care about climate change. And that's the thing, because we respond to threats that are personal, abrupt, immoral, that happen right here, right now. That's when we take action. Climate change is nothing like that. It's this abstract thing that will happen sometime in the future to some people on small islands. And well, this means that we only process it on a rational level. And when you think about something like this, a threatening message, you first consider, well, will this change something about me? Will something happen to me? And if that is the case, then we think, can we do something about it? And if that is not clear, we become anxious. We become afraid even, because the consequences, if we can't do anything about it, they're inevitable. So we hide here in the bottom because that is not clear. What can we do? So I want now to talk about what we can do. All these articles of threatening messages, they just make us afraid. So I want to try to get you to take one first step, to take an action. For instance, you could do one of these three kinds of actions. You could get informed. You could spread the word, get the facts, like I'm doing right here, right now. But you could also go to the government and say, I want this. They're there to serve you, so tell them what you want. You can also choose to be an example, to go here by bike, or to consume less meat, or less other luxuries. And you can also, well, try to investigate where the things you're buying, where they come from. Because we make a lot of bad choices, because we have no idea what goes into making these products. And every time you spend a euro on something, you're saying, I want this product in the world. So that's why I said vote consciously, not buy. So I want all of you to pick one of these three. And it doesn't have to be a concrete action, it can just be a feeling, but I want you just to pick one of these three and take the first step now. So if you're going to do the first thing, if you're going to get informed in some way, maybe just read one article. Stand up now, please. And if you choose to be an example, to maybe bike more or eat less meat or anything like that, please stand up as well. Great. So if you're in a third group that wants to spend their money wisely and spend their time on good things, please also stand up. Now we're all standing again, together. Thank you all so very much. Thank you.